in darkness. We are not the people remaining in darkness and seeking the light, but we bring the light, take the light into darkness. This is what we proclaim, the word, the light. That's why Jesus said in John's Gospel, chapter 1, verse 4 and 5, he came into the world as the light, and he shines in darkness. In the beginning was the word, and the word was God, and the word became light, and that light shines in darkness, and the darkness could not overcome it. What a great word. When you proclaim the word, when you open your mouth and proclaim the word of God, light will come. Through light, life will come. Darkness will disappear. So many temptations, so many disturbances, so many ways of evil will come and attack you. Don't worry about darkness. You need not to fight with the darkness. God has not called you to fight with the darkness. Let the light, let the word, hold on to the word, which is the sword of the spirit. The enemy will be destroyed. Hold on to the promises of God. Continue to proclaim. Man will live by the word. So to live a conqueror life, victorious life, God has called you and me. God anointed Jesus with the Holy Spirit to prove to the world, right? Satan, come, we will prove who is strong. And Jesus conquered the enemy. Today, God sends you and me into this world of Satan with the sword of the Spirit. Prove to the world, my word is sufficient to destroy the works of evil. Protect yourself and protect everyone, and live with this mighty source of life, the word of God. And second, we find in the temptation of Jesus in Matthew chapter 4, Jesus was taken to Jerusalem temple, and Jesus was shown this beautiful world. He tried to attack with his body, he could not. Now he tries to attack Jesus with the world. Look how nightclubs are going on. Look how they are drinking. Look how they are dancing. You can enjoy all this, man. Come on. He was trying to. And the Lord spoke to him. Satan doesn't want Jesus to speak the word of God. So Satan himself quotes the word of God now. But what did Jesus say? Do not test your God. Do you know to whom you are talking? Don't test the Lord who is in me. The consciousness of the Lord in us is must to bring our potentiality out. We need to be conscious. Seeing God in ourselves is necessary to see our potential and our call on this earth. Because life doesn't resolve around us, but it resolves around Christ who is in us. So we need to be aware of the Lord in us. And we have to tell Satan, don't test me, for the Lord is in me. Conscious of the Lord in us is must to conquer the enemy. The more we are conscious, that's what Paul said in Romans chapter 8, verse 32 onwards. If God is for us, who can be against us? When the Lord who has loved me and gave his life for me is in me, who can separate me against from his love? Neither sin nor the dirty things in the world or any pleasure or any angels. Nothing can separate me from the love of Christ. Even if I have fallen, the moment I run to him, Daddy, I'm sorry. Unknowingly it has happened, Daddy. I made a commitment, I will not fall.
But I fell, but I will not lose courage. You are with me. I will see his blood cleansing me, once again making me his child. That's why St. Paul says, don't you know that you are the temple of the Holy Spirit and God is in you? 1 Corinthians chapter 3 verse 16. Yes. So the Lord teaches us the temptation of the world will come. You have to tell them, you are nothing in front of my Lord who is in me. So to conquer the temptation of the world, you have to conquer, be aware of the Lord in you. The more we are conscious of the Lord in us, we see my hands belong to the Lord, my feet belongs to the Lord, my walking belongs to the Lord, my God goes before me. This is the secret David had. In Psalm 16, he said, I saw the Lord always before me. He is at my right hand, so I will not be shaken. The more we are conscious of the Lord in us, the more we are conscious of the Lord who is leading us. That's what he said in Micah chapter 3. Your God goes before you, breaking every barriers and giving victory to you. Yes. That's what we read in the book of 2 Corinthians chapter 2 verse 24. We are victorious, for our God goes before us with a victorious right hand and gives us the sweet smelling fragrance of the word of God. Yes. We go around spreading the word of God, the sweet fragrance. Praise the Lord. Yes. We live by him. That's what, when the world trying to defeat the great servant of God, Job, his wife did not understand him. His wife made fun of him. Curse your God, man. God, 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 you are saying. If God is with you, why these things are happening? You lost your children. You lost your property. You lost everything. Curse God and die, man. He calls the servants. They show their back. Three friends came to console him. Instead of consoling, they began to abuse him. Without sin, nobody will suffer. You have secret sins. And Job said in Job chapter 19, verse 25, I know one thing for sure, my Redeemer is living with me. My Redeemer is not dead, he is alive, he is with me. And one day I will see him face to face. And he will tell me, he will show me, why did he allow all these things in my life? I know for my good he is allowing. With my little brain, I am not able to understand what he does in my life. Many things he doesn't give it to me, what I desire. Because he will do according to what is best for me. With my little mind, I don't understand. But one thing for sure, my Redeemer is living. My Redeemer lives. The more we are conscious of the Lord in us, we will conquer the enemy and live a victorious life. Now, third, Satan is taking Jesus to the high mountain and tells him, you worship me, I will give you everything. Jesus says, do you know I have the power? With the tip of my finger, I can cast you out. Do you know? I have the power. My Father has endowed me with the power. Jesus was conscious of the power and said, get out. And Satan ran away. Enemy will come after you.
But you should be conscious of the power he has given to you.
Yes. You should be aware of the power he has given to you.
My dear friends, Sangamam Plus TV is God's gift for you for our times. Like, comment, share and subscribe. God will do wonders in your life. Praise the Lord.